Okay, so welcome back to the second part of the tutorial. So I have a whole lot of layers and stuff here. So I'm just gonna delete this flowers copy, all right? And I'm gonna go through and delete some of these other layers that are unnecessary. So this one is not necessary anymore. Just have a look at these. I might keep that one because I might use it later as a little embellishment. I might keep that one too. And that one. I'm going to delete that. So I didn't use all the layers that I brought in, but that's fine. Okay, and all right, so I'm just going to drag all the layers that are my text up to the top because I do have different ones. Oops, doesn't want to work. I'll show that. I don't need that. So just go ahead and delete it. Otherwise, your workspace is going to get really overcrowded. All right, so I've got my S. I'll bring it up to the top. So these ones here, and all I need to do, I want to put all of the layers that says flowers there together. So I actually kept my O and copied it and made it as a pink O, and I might actually just change the color of that. So I'm going to go image, adjust, hue, saturation. I'm going to make a little bit lighter so it will match with the others. Keep the saturation up and maybe make it a little bit less purple. No. So it matches a little bit better. Okay, so I have my flowers here and I've got this is the O, I've got the S, the F and the E, and the rest of the letters. So I want to make them all come together, and all I can do is I can select on layer 13 to through layer 12. It may be different for you, and I can just press Command and E, or I can go to layer and merge layers. Okay, so I'm going to press Command E as a shortcut. And these now become one layer. So this is, I'm going to call this text. All right. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to show you two things that you can do to create a kind of interesting effect. Actually, I'm going to show you three. So the first thing that you can do is using this original flowers font, I'd like you to duplicate this again. So duplicate the layer, just okay. All right, turn that original one off. And we're going to, again, rasterize it, make it a shape. All right, and it's black already. So all we need to do, I want to make the flowers kind of stand out and have a bit of a shadow behind them. All right, and this is something you can do as a standalone thing. So I'm going to go to filter, blur, and then box blur. Okay, and you see, immediately this kind of thing will come up, and I don't want it to be too strong. So actually, I might bring it out a little bit more. Press OK, and then I'm going to bring the opacity of that layer down so it just kind of stands out a little bit. So you can see if I turn it off or I turn it on, it can stand out more or less. Okay, so that font begins to stand out and become a little bit more 3D. All right, so that's one thing that you could do. All right, the second thing that you can do, using that flowers thing again, all right, is duplicate it. Turn the eye off so you can't see it. Rasterize it again. Okay. And we're going to flip it over and make it turn into a shadow. So what we're going to do, we're going to go edit, transform, and we're going to flip vertically. All right. So now this image has become vertical, and I'm going to just very carefully match it to here. All right. And as you can see, all right, it's matched. However, I would like to make it a little bit more shadow-ish, so I want to make it coming out on an angle. So what I'm going to do is transform and skew it. Okay, so I'm just actually zoom out a little bit so you can see this. Transform skew, and then I'm going to pull this out this side and pull this out this side, just kind of making it come out from there. All right, as the shadow would if it was being hit from behind and then going straight out. And I don't want it to be black because it's really like too strong. So I'm just going to bring the opacity down and make it kind of stand out like that. All right, so it does look a little bit more shadow-like. Okay, so that's the second thing that you could do. And obviously you could work both of those two things together. All right, finally, I'm going to delete that. And with the text copy selected, the final thing that I want to show you how to do is to make it 3D. So let's just go to layer and layer style. So there's a few different things that you could do, and I'd like you to play around in here and come up with what you think is the best. But I'm just going to show you a bevel and emboss. So that's it makes the font come up and like this, kind of become 3D. So bevel and emboss it. Okay, and I'm going to do an inner bevel. Okay, keep it smooth. And I'd like the depth to be a little bit more. The size, I'm going to do it to here. And maybe let's make it a little bit softer. All right, and you can play around with this as well. And all these things are going to affect it in different ways. At the moment, this is the angle of it. I could change it like this. You can see how it's changing here. I kind of like that. And I can make what is like the shiny stuff change. Okay, so it becomes a bit more solid, and fiddle around with these things and press OK. So that is something. I also can make my font come out. It becomes 3D, and immediately I get a really cool effect, and it really shows, while it's still got those images in there, it's so much more interesting than just having plain font to illustrate that. So I'd really love to see your work. Go ahead and feel free to upload it onto Schoology, onto our discussion page. Make sure you take screenshots as you go, okay? So as you're doing different things, take a screenshot and add those into your diary as evidence of your work. And yeah, have fun learning all these new and exciting things. All right, have a great day.